Hello. Welcome here. Without further ado, let me get Curtis. This guy right here. Yeah.
Thank you, David. Yeah, I just wanted to say a few words about getting them here. I really appreciate you guys pulling it off. Over here?
Yeah.
Beam me up, Scotty. The way I found out about Choro Das Tres is the YouTube. And kind of chokes me up. I love their music so much. They were playing Paganini Brasileiro, and it's a beautiful piece. I think they're gonna play it tonight. But I started, following them online, and they do a free concert online every Thursday, and there's a whole catalog of them. You can tune in them, just like with these guys, what they do here. And I think they're up to 178 shows. So if you can't get enough, also they'll have CDs available and T-shirts back here too. But anyway, I just really proud to have them come to St. Louis, and I hope they can come back again. And without further ado, I think if you put your hands together, they just might come out. Give them a hearty hot St. Louis welcome. Choro Das Tres. Thank you.
evening. Boa noite. We are Choro das Três. We are three sisters from Brazil. We live in the countryside of São Paulo State in a little town called Porto Feliz. And this is our eighth USA tour. We do a cross-country tour from coast to coast. And we are very excited for this tour. We've been away since the pandemics. And it's our first time here. So thank you so much for having us. We are very excited to be here. We have a motorhome. That's where we live while we are on tour. And when we were arriving here last night, we were so amazed by the town and how beautiful it is. And we are really enjoying it here. So we just started with a Zero, a classic, a composition by Pixinguinha and Benedito Lacerda. A Zero translates to 1-0. That was about a soccer game, of course. Now we'll play a composition by Elisa. That's a frevo, right, Elisa?
Yes, good evening. Boa noite. Frevo is a kind of music from northeastern Brazil. Frevo comes from the word ferver, which means to boil. So you can imagine they're always like very fast and they very happy. They play for the carnival from that region. And the food, where we are from, the food is not spicy. We don't eat spicy, but in the northeastern, it's very spicy. So the name of this tune is apimentado, spicy.
Thank you. So Elisa is gonna play that instrument. It's a banjo, a tenor banjo. And it's a special banjo. It was a gift from a friend in the New England area. That banjo belonged to his father, so it's a 1920 banjo made in Providence, Rhode Island, and it's all metal. Show them the back of the banjo. Yeah.
Very heavy.
So that banjo doesn't go to Brazil because it's very heavy to carry. It stays in the New England area.
So we are going to play a very old choro piece by Honorino Lopes. It's called Língua de Preto. It means black talk. Because in the old days, black people in Brazil, they had an accent that when they talked would go from the high notes to the low notes, something like...
It was very musical.
It was very musical. And the composer portrayed that on the music, on this music. So, Língua de Preto. Obrigada. The next one is a composition by me in honor to our grandfather. He had a little ranch in our town, and he was very good with plants, and he cultivated this Brazilian fruit called jabuticaba. And he had several trees of that, and he had also two trees of a rare kind of jabuticaba called olho de boi. So if you've never seen a jabuticaba, it's a fruit that looks like a berry. It's very dark.
Black, purple, like a blueberry. Yeah, like same black color, probably. Yeah.
It's a berry, and it grows on the...
bark.
On the bark of the tree, since the bottom until the top of the tips of the branches. So it's very beautiful. And usually the regular jabuticaba is like this size. And the olho de boi, the rare kind, the translation would be bull's eye. It's like bigger. And it's very rare, and he loved those trees, so I named the tune after this fruit, Olho de Boi, and also turned out to be the name of our album. So we're gonna play that one, Olho de Boi.
Thank you.
So now we are going to play one of our compositions. It's inspired by fado music. So fado is a kind of music they play in Portugal. It's very deep and many times very sad. Because if you think of Portuguese people, they were brave sailors, right? So if you see the fado singers, they are always wearing a black dress, black long dress. Because all the women in Portugal lost someone to the ocean. So these kids, the sons or brothers or husbands, fathers, they would go out in these expeditions, and very few of them would come back. Most of them would never come back. So there is this big grief in Portuguese music. And so we as Brazilians that speak Portuguese and have a lot of their culture, for example, the mandolin, the Brazilian mandolin has the shape of a Portuguese guitar. So this mandolin was created in Brazil by Jacó do Bandolim to play choro music, because choro means to cry or to weep in English. Same like the blues. And because we have some songs that are very sad, and because the guitar play on the low strings, so they thought that, Jacó thought that the Neapolitan, the Italian mandolin, was not sentimental enough. You had to play a lot of tremolos to hold the notes. So he brought the Portuguese guitar, a body shape, to the mandolin, so the notes would resonate longer. And because of that, the way we play the mandolin in Brazil has a lot to do to the way the Portuguese play the Portuguese guitar, with vibratos, and it's a different way than mandolinists usually play the mandolin. So this is a composition that we all did together. It's called Alma Portuguesa, Portuguese Soul. Starts with a fado, with Portugal, and then the C section is a little bit of Brazil. Obrigada. So you can imagine the three of us, our mother, our two dogs, getting to the airport in May to come to the US with all these instruments, everything, our suitcases. What a mess. So now we're going to play a composition by Pedro Raimundo. It's called Escadaria. And I'm going to play this instrument. This is a pandeiro. You guys call it tambourine, right? For us, this is called a pandeiro. This is the instrument that my father played. And Choro das Três is 22 years old this year. We've been playing together as a band for 22 years. And for 19 of these 22 years, my father was sitting right here playing pandeiro, whistling, being our biggest fan, our biggest supporter, being the driver of our tours and being able to fix everything, and our best friend. And we lost him for COVID 2 years ago. So this is our first tour without him. And he taught all of us how to play a little bit of pandeiro. Of course, I'm not as great as he was. He was a great pandeiro player. But we like to bring a little bit of his sound to our concerts, so we feel he's here with us. So that's for him.
Vira esse microfone mais para a grade ali. Thank you.
Obrigada. The next one is one composition by me that I did on the accordion. It's called Baião de Luz. Baião is another genre from northeastern Brazil, older than forró, and I think it's probably the father of all the genres in northeastern Brazil. It's called Baião. And de luz means of light. So Baião of light.
Obrigada, thank you very much. So we'll play one more and we'll have a break, okay? We'll have a break for it and we'll come back for the second set. We have our guest book over there. So if you can, please sign our guest book, leave your name and email, and we'll sign you up to our mailing list and we'll let you know where we are gonna be. We are going to be traveling a lot. This tour is going to be at least 1 year long. And so we'll go, next week we'll be in Chicago, and then we go to Indiana for Terre Haute, and Michigan, and Texas, and Florida in January. And yeah, well, we have to survive, you know. This is freaking cold for us already. I don't know what would happen to us if we stayed in a cold place, cold for American standards, for January. I mean, our dog didn't leave her bed all day today. She's very moody.
Right?
That's true.
Sorry?
It was 85 yesterday.
Yes, we were in Tennessee, and it was nice and warm with a t-shirt and jeans, and then we arrived here. We are staying in a very nice campground in St. Peter's, Lakeside RV Park. Yes, it's lovely there, but when I arrived, we arrived at night at 9:10 p.m., so I opened the door of the RV to get out and check in, and I'm like, oh my gosh, my soul left my body for a minute. So we'll play, the last one is gonna be a bossa nova for you guys. So many people think that my dad and my mom wanted us to be professional musicians and forced us to play. But no, they tried to convince us to not be professional musicians. But it didn't work. My dad, when he was in high school, that was when my mother met him, he used to play with his friends just for fun. And bossa nova was the main thing that they played, and some samba. So every time we play bossa nova, we think of him. And this one is very well known here in the U.S., so maybe you guys can sing with us. This, since we are not singers, so you can help us. This is called Só Danço Samba. Do you guys know it?
Yeah?
By Tom Jobim. So for those that don't know, here are the lyrics. Só danço samba. Só danço samba. Vai, 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 vai.
It means I only dance samba.
Yeah, I only dance samba, I only dance samba. And vai, vai, vai would be something like yeah, 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 yeah. Okay? And then, só danço samba, só danço samba, vai. Yeah, okay. One vai, two vai. Só danço samba, vai, 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 vai. Só danço samba, só danço samba, vai. Só danço samba, só danço samba, vai, 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 vai. Só danço samba, só danço samba, vai. Já dancei o twist até demais. Mas não sei me cansar.
flip, swap, cha cha cha. Só dança samba, só dança samba.
Welcome back. So, you know, I think that the band is still in the back, actually. They're kind of hanging out back there, but you know, if you make a bunch of noise, they might be willing to come to this side of the room.
Obrigada, thank you. So, Curtis, who is the reason that we are here, why we are here tonight, asked us to play Bolinha de Gude, that means marbles. That is a composition by Elisa that she composed when she was a kid in elementary school. And the boys in her class didn't let her play marbles with them. So, filled with all the revenge, she went home and she said, I'm gonna compose something and they will not be able to play it too. So that's the revenge of a kid, marbles. Humidity changing when we were in Tennessee and then we are here and it's the instruments are always adapting.
Thank you.
Thank you. Obrigada. The next one that Curtis asked us to play is probably the most difficult piece I play. That's a long time I don't play it, but we're gonna do it for him, for you, thank Curtis. And I'm sorry if I make any mistake. It's been a long time we don't play this piece. It's actually it's called in Portuguese it's called valsa concerto. The title is Quando Me Lembro, when I remember. The composer was a very important, one of the great masters of the Brazilian mandolin. He's not very known outside Brazil. His name was Luperce Miranda. He was from Pernambuco. And he was actually, he came before Jacob the Bandolin. And he was actually the responsible for making the mandolin part of the choro ensembles and because before that, even for accompanying singers, you could not find any recordings of mandolin in Brazil. It was not very popular. And after him, because he was such a virtuoso, he was called
the Brazilian Paganini.
Yeah, he was called the Brazilian Paganini of the mandolin, and because of him, people started to want to play the mandolin, including Jacob Bandolin. If you like this kind of information, I've been writing for a site called the Mandolin Cafe. And every month I write something about a Brazilian mandolin player or about choro. And for coincidence, this month I've been writing about Luperce Miranda. So I'm in his vibe. So let's try. Quando me lembro.
Thank you.
Elisa Meyer on the mandolin and Leah on the 7-string guitar. Now we are gonna play a composition of Elisa and her mandolin BFF. So when we started to play Choro, we started to go to São Paulo, that is 1.5-2 hours away from where we live, to play with the mentors, the masters of this style of music. And all of them could be our grandparents. They were way older than us. But what was very beautiful is the way they treated us, the respect they had for us as musicians. So Paulo Fasanaro and many others never allowed us to call them sir, because they used to say, in music, we are all the same. We just sit and play together. And Paulo Fasanaro became Elisa's BFF. So they would call each other and gossip about other mandolin players.
And talk about picks.
And talk about picks. For hours, and try each other's peaks and all kinds of things, right? Doing this?
Yes, and just it's nice that it was coincidence that we played this piece by Luperce Miranda, and now we're gonna play this piece by Mr. Paulo Fasanaro and I, because Mr. Paulo was probably one of the first people to tell me about Luperce Miranda. Because he came from the same place as Luperce Miranda, and he used to tell me that he saw Luperce Miranda playing live many times and at jam sessions, and he was so amazed. I remember his eyes telling me about about Luperce Miranda's playing. He was astonished until, like, 40 years after it, he was still, like, amazed. He used to say that he could play all over the neck of the mandolin without looking at it and looking around and doing it. He was, like, in Portuguese, we say assombroso. He was, like, scary. It was so good that it was scary.
But Brazilians in the audience, help us. How do we translate that?
Scary would probably be.
Close.
Como é que afina aqui?
Quebrou a fia?
Não. Toca você uma nota para mim.
The name of the piece is Do Coração ao Bandolim, From the Heart to the Mandolin. Thank you. Obrigada, thank you. That was a samba composition by Candeia, and it's called Preciso Me Encontrar. So samba is another style of music from Brazil. And choro is the essence of Brazilian soul, as Villa-Lobos used to say. And samba is the voice of the people. It's the kind of music that everybody sings together and forgets about their problems and get together and have fun. And so it's a very beautiful kind of music too. But now we are going to play a style of music that is common in the south of South America, especially in the borders. So between Brazil and Uruguay, Brazil and Argentina, there's a lot, Paraguay, a lot of this music called chamamé. So my grandfather, the other grandfather, the father of my father, loved the south of Brazil and Uruguay also. And he lived in Porto Alegre for a while. He learned how to make the best barbecue there. And he always loved and talked about the south of Brazil. So Elisa never met him because he passed away when she was not born yet. But everybody that met my grandfather always had something very good to tell about him. So she composed this chamamé and named it Nobre Coração, Noble Heart. Thank you.
Thank you.
Obrigada. So choro is a style of music that appeared in Brazil. It started in Brazil in the 19th century. And it was the Brazilian way of playing the music that came from Europe. The Brazilian way included some African drum feelings, some native also feelings to the music, and classical musicians, especially flute players, piano players, would get together with guitar players, cavaquinho players, and they would challenge each other and improvise and challenge in a way that to see who could play the most difficult pieces or who could do more modulations. And so it was really a kind of music created from musicians to for other musicians. So that's why playing choro is so hard, because the only reason that choro was created was to entertain musicians. So the level is very high. And so we're going to play a song for you guys, a piece that is a classical piece. And that piece carries this challenging spirit that we love in choro music. So this was composed by Vittorio Monti, an Italian composer, who used to play the violin, but also the mandolin. So that piece was composed for the mandolin. And this is called Xardas or Chardas. Thank you. Obrigada. Thank you very much. So we'll play our last one. And we'd like to say thank you so much. It was great to play for you guys. We loved coming to St. Louis. We hope this is the first of many, many times. And special thanks to Kurtz, because we don't have an agent. We play instrumental music, and everything you saw in our merch table, it was recorded, mixed, mastered, arranged, composed. The paintings were made by Elisa. The designs of the shirts were made by us. The shirts used to be embroidered by us. We started to embroider our own shirts during the pandemic. That was my dad's idea. So we used to play our live feed concerts on YouTube every Thursday and sell our merch. And that's how we made through the pandemic with no concerts at all. And now my aunt that is back in Brazil, we taught her how to embroider, and she's doing the embroidering, and she sends these 50-pound boxes with T-shirts for us in the mail. So everything there is made with so much care and love, and it's the same of this tour. So people like Kurtz make this tour possible, because if it wasn't by people like him, I would never be able to find a place like this and come to this town. And obrigada. So thank you, the focal point too, and all the volunteers. It's amazing what you guys do here. And we hope to see you guys back next year, maybe.
And I'd like to thank someone, I think in name of all of us, if it wasn't for Corina, our big sister, we wouldn't be here in the U.S. because after my father's passing, we didn't even know if we were going to keep playing. Imagine if we were going to think about coming to the U.S. and living in an RV and get sell the old RV and buy the newer RV. So it was all Corina's idea, and she was really encouraging us. And she's all the responsible. She's the bravest person because she's the one driving the bus. So thank you. And she was right. I think it was the best thing for us to come to the U.S. I know that when you live in a place, you forget. Because of the bad things, the bad news, you kind of forget. But us that are coming here now, it's such a wonderful country. The more we get to know it, like places like here, especially we didn't know much of this part of the country. Each park is more beautiful than the other. The nature here is so beautiful. The people are so amazing. So
kind.
It was the best idea. Thank you.
The 7-string guitar, Leo, ladies and gentlemen. On the mandolin, clarinet, and banjo, Elisa.